I was born in Beirut, Lebanon, in 1954. I started medical school in 1976. And in the middle of that year, the civil war started in Lebanon. So we ended up taking our lectures in the basement and sleeping in the basement, and pretty much stayed there day and night with our professors because we wanted to finish the year. And at the end of the year, then we all managed to get out of the campus. So it was quite a scary time because the bombs were literally falling all around the campus. I came as a visitor. I was thinking, I came with this one suitcase of summer clothes. I came with a mindset, I'm here for 3 months. The war will be over soon. I'm going back to start my second year medical school in October. I don't feel the anti-immigrant spirit because I'm surrounded by immigrants. So most people in science are, quite a few of them are immigrants. So we're really quite an international community. I was really worried about the state of affairs of education, science, research here, if we're going to limit immigration. So that was a huge concern to me. I really do hope that this country will continue to have open doors to immigrants. Unfortunately, we've noticed decline. There are many countries that don't, I mean, applicants don't come here anymore. They prefer to go to Europe because of the concern and the difficulties and all the bureaucracy that's now makes it very challenging for immigrants to come here. I run a lab that's dedicated to understanding how certain genes, when altered, can cause terrible neurological diseases, both childhood neurological diseases and adult degenerative diseases. So I spend my time thinking how we're going to solve these problems and what would be the best path to one day have a treatment that might make these patients better. I'm trained as a child neurologist, which also, that means you also know how to do adult neurology because you combine the training. And I'm also trained as a molecular geneticist, which means you're trained to know how to use molecular genetic tools to map disease genes and clone disease genes. It was when I saw patients, especially children, with neurological disorders that I decided to go and start all over a new career in research and get tooled in using techniques that might help me discover the causes of these diseases so that maybe I can do something about them. So I set out to study two different diseases. One of them is a childhood neurological disease called Rett syndrome. So I wanted to find the cause of that disease. I wanted to find the gene. And it was very hard to find this gene because this is not an inherited disorder. This is one in a family, so it was quite a long, long adventure to find it. But we did find it, and I consider that really one of the most important things I've done. Creativity is important in anything we do, right? Because you have to think about things differently to solve problems, and you have to think about things differently to produce a beautiful piece of art or a new piece of music. In sciences, if you're not creative, the advances in opening up new fields may be limited. The exchange of ideas will aid the creative process. I wanted to solve Rett syndrome. I worry about it day and night. I think about it always, but then I think about it also in out-of-the-box ways because I'm determined to find a way. And that's part of the process. The other part, you share these thoughts with others and they get refined and it helps your creative process. So I think it's a combination, some from within and some from the outside. The personal motivation was the children I've met with this problem. And it was, you know, it started with one particular patient who is very dear to my heart. But then I saw many other girls with the same problem, and I was really intrigued, and I was, you know, moved by the plight of these families where these girls started life knowing how to do everything, and then it's all lost and they're arrested in the situation. And I felt we have to figure out what causes this problem because maybe we can unlock it one day. Nothing I'm doing today was ever anticipated. Because once I went to medical school, once I yielded to my pressures of my mother to go to medical school and I went to medical school, I thought I'm going to be a pediatrician working in Beirut, seeing kids, and that will be my life. I never thought I'll end up in the United States of America. It was never on my radar screen. That's in the first place. Then to become a neurologist after that, and then to go into research, this was absolutely not planned. When I reflect on my career, which is 20 years now in science, and think when we started where the genes were unknown for many neurological diseases, where now they're known for over hundreds of these diseases, the tools, I never imagined we could model any disease that we study in a mouse and put the same type of mutation in the mouse, and when the mouse would replicate the features of the human disease. I never imagined that. I never imagined the tools we have today, the imaging tools where we can see dendrites, where, you know, the little spines on nerve cells, where we can label proteins and fluorescently and watch them moving across different compartments of the cell. When you think about all the advances, and when you think about all the technology that's available today, I think it's been an amazing 20 years, and it's really a wonderful opportunity for us to understand how our brains work, what goes wrong, how might we protect them. And this is also true in cancer and immunology. I just focus on the brain, that's my area. So we've come a long way. There's one more thing I'd like to do, make a patient better. So I'd like to continue to pursue investigations that might help us get closer to therapies. And really, I will finally feel I accomplished what I set out to do in the first place when we actually make some patients better. Many immigrants come here not speaking English. Many immigrants come here leaving behind family and friends. They're all alone. Many of them come from cultural backgrounds so different from here. They have to adapt. They often don't have any resources, are poor. So they all come with so many challenges, and yet they seem to make it. It's drive to survive that immigrants realize, if I don't work hard and really overcome these challenges, I'm not going to make it. I'm sure each of you will have challenges, but if you look at history and you look how this country was founded and look at all the wonderful people that came before us and made it what it is, you would realize what a great opportunity this country provides to any new immigrant and what a difference you will make. So I would just say, don't give up. As bad as it may seem, it will get better and you will make a huge difference.